AI just made Photoshop better. And expensive. If you are in Arch-Viz, here's the plan. I'm going to show you the exact features that save you time, and the ones that drain credits and give you nothing. I'm Aga from Arch-Viz Artist. Here we test stuff so you don't have to burn time or money. Let's start with the elephant in the room. Credits. I'm not going to explain Adobe's credit system, because I don't understand it either, but that's the point. It's so complicated, I would probably have to do 1 hour video just about that. That's not even the worst part. I found it ridiculous that there is no information on how many credits will be used to perform an action. It's like you go to the store and find out how much Apple costs, only after the purchase, or after you read and most importantly understand the terms and conditions. Transparency is important. Put a simple counter in the app and one stable page with real numbers like we have in Comfy, for example, then we have no problem. Hope this is fixed in the future. Now let's focus on the updates. I will start with the upscalers. Adobe has announced several new partnerships. One of them is the collaboration with Topaz. It is one of the most used upscalers, and now we have access to it directly in Photoshop. You can see that this image here is quite small. To upscale it, we go to Image and then select Generative Upscale. Here we have the different options to choose from. We can pick the Firefly upscaler or one of the two partner models. Using partner models will cost you credits, but I don't know how much. I will start with the Firefly model. Then we specify how big the upscale should be. Hit upscale and wait. Here is how it looks. Overall, not bad. Even though we use the 4x upscaler, the effect looks more like a 2x upscaler. It's not super crisp. Let's zoom in on the garden area. It did a good job with the plants and the gravel. It's not super sharp, but it looks natural. Next, let's test the Topaz Gigapixel. We go back to Image, choose Generative Upscale, Topaz Gigapixel, choose the Output Scale, and hit Upscale. This one is a bit faster. Here is the comparison between Topaz and Firefly. I am not a fan of the Topaz Gigapixel output, and I definitely wouldn't use it in this case. Firefly is a clear winner here. I tried using Topaz Bloom as well, and that was the biggest disappointment. Let me show you. Next, let me compare the Photoshop update with my go-to upscaler in ComfyUI and with Magnific AI. I think it's not even a question here. Comfy did a way better job. Keep in mind that Comfy's output will be slightly different from the original image, which I actually prefer. It's a great way to improve natural elements that look fake in 3D. Let's compare Comfy to Magnific as well. Comfy's output is better than Magnific too, plus Comfy is free. This is why in our AI course, we go free first and control first with ComfyUI. Our goal is to show you how to integrate AI into your Arch-Viz workflow. With our course, you could work easier, finish faster, and produce more. Join the AI in Arch-Viz course now. You've got 36 hours to get it in pre-order at the best price. The next update, the Topaz Sharpen. If I wanted to use the Firefly upscaler, I would probably pair it with the Sharpen option from Topaz. Let's test that on this image. We go to Filter and choose AI Sharpen. This opens a window notifying us that we're about to use a premium feature powered by a partner model. We're gonna to pay for that, but again, no idea how much. There are no options available, so just click Sharpen and wait for it to process. I hope you can see it clearly on the screen, but I think this did a good job. It added a bit of extra sharpness to the image without making it look too fake. Next, the Select Subject tool was improved a lot. It now handles complex scenes much better, even things like bicycles. I don't want to use real people for this demo, so I've generated a quick image of a guy riding a bike. Let's test the Select Subject option. Now, we are able to do it locally, without sending it to the cloud. If you remember the old version, you know that getting fine details like the metal spokes on the wheels was nearly impossible. Now, even with this AI twisted spokes, the selection is perfectly clean. A few small elements stayed, but with a cleaner image, something more like a real photo, it probably would have done a better job. The area around the hair is also surprisingly good. You could refine it a bit more with Select and Mask, but overall, it's a really solid improvement. Let's see another new feature. Inpaint with reference. Nano Banana is great, but the Inpaint with Reference feature in Photoshop hasn't really worked properly. The reference option is fully grayed out, even though Gemini works perfectly with multiple images. The new Firefly version, though, looks promising. You can choose to reference either the full image or just a specific object, and then decide whether to swap the selected area or place the object in the marked selection. Let's try the swap option. This worked, but I'm not too impressed. It placed the plant in a slightly different location. It also removed part of the image that was not supposed to be removed. There is potential, but also a lot of work to do. If we compare the results with what we got in ComfyUI, I can say there is no match. In Comfy, we have way more control and are able to generate the results that can be shipped to clients. Again, don't miss out and join our course where we will show you all the workflows we are using at the moment. Let's take one of the images from our visualization training and test the remove tool. I really like this tool and rarely use anything else to remove elements, unless Photoshop can handle it. We can choose the remove tool and then specify what model we want to use. The next step is to paint around the object you want to remove. Let's use this lamp so we can see how the new model handles the stone wall behind it. We'll then make a comparison between the new model and the old one. I'll rename this layer and duplicate the original one to remove the lamp using the old model. Then we'll zoom in and compare the two results. With the old model selected, make a new area around the lamp. You can already see the difference between the two versions, but let me zoom in so we can take a closer look. This is the old model, and this is the new one. The difference in this image isn't huge, but it's still noticeable. The new model performed very well on the stone wall area, and it's hard to spot any seams. The old model, however, created a strange halo near the ceiling. So the conclusion is that I'll continue using Photoshop. Outpainting is another feature that was already very good, and it just got better. Using it is simple. Switch to crop mode, drag the crop out to cover the area you want to expand. Click Generative Expand and choose the latest model. Hit Generate and wait for it to process. You can choose between 3 generations, just like in the previous version, and they're all very good. I'll zoom in to show you the details. Okay, I do the same to expand the image to the right side. Here are the 3 versions of the side extension. It's almost impossible to spot the seam. I quickly repeated the process using the old model. The improvement here is big. This is another task I usually complete in Photoshop. The outpainting might look better in Flux or other models, but the ease of use in Photoshop makes it my go-to tool for this kind of work. That said, the new model is even better than the old one, and it's hard to match, even in Comfy or any other model. Let's take a look at another improved tool, the Harmonize. It's been around since the last round of updates, and it used to be quite useful. But now, I think it's not as helpful anymore, and I'll show you why. I've added here a group of people talking on a separate layer. Using the Harmonize option couldn't be easier. With the target layer selected, click Harmonize and wait for it to process. Here's why I don't like it that much. The image quality is compromised. It does a good job with highlights and shadows, but the people need to be recovered. Also, I'm not entirely sure the colors are accurate. I'd need to check them, but something feels a bit off. Let me show you why I think this feature is almost no longer relevant. First of all, Generative Fill now works properly, and you can simply type your prompt and get exactly what you asked for. In this case, I'm asking for a group of elegant people talking before a wedding ceremony. I'm not adding anything else to the prompt, I'm just letting Firefly do its job. Now, take a look at this. This is about the same level as you can get with Nano Banana. I don't like the person in the back, and I'll need to do a bit of masking in and out, since it also replicated part of the background, but it's a fairly quick fix. Let's try the place option again with a reference image and see if it works better this time. It didn't do an amazing job with the plant in the previous scene, but I think it will perform better here. We'll use the same group of people we added earlier as a reference. The scale is off, but that's an easy fix. Let's create a mask around the people and group them so we can rescale and adjust by painting in and out certain areas. Generative Fill looks better than the one with Harmonize tool, and we didn't even have to fix the perspective. At this point, Harmonize can be checked off the list. Want better results faster? We test AI tools and build ready-to-use proven workflows. With our methods, you can slash your production time, stop wasting time, and start creating more. Enroll in AI for Arch-Viz today.